To all of those who are joining us for the first time viewers and watchers of this program, it's not an accident that you have tuned in today. It is the Father's perfect appointment and time for you, because the Father is calling thousands of His children to the great harvest today. So I thank the Father also for all of the new full-time miracle workers who are joining me in the bountiful, abundant, and fruitful harvest of souls to become sons and daughters all over the Philippines and all over the world. I thank the Father that the message that I've been completed for months, completion of salvation is upon us, and this is the hope of every soul. This is the hope of humanity, and this is the hope by which man can find the broken relationship between him and the Almighty Father brought back. I thank the Father that today, when the Father opens up the gates of the door of salvation, anyone who is hungry and thirsty for that salvation will find completion in the Father's work of salvation. This is your ark of salvation today. Praise the Almighty Father. Every question in our hearts are being answered. Lahat ng tanong sa ating mga buhay tungkol sa kaligtasan, nasagot ng lahat. Tanang mga pangutana na wala na to nasulbad sa una, karon nasulbad na tanan. All of those questions are being answered today by the message of the Almighty Father through His appointed Son. And so, I thank the Father for that the ramparts and the walls, thick walls of religious deception are going down. For example, the religious deception of our belief that had been fed to us, that those doctrines have been exposed against the true doctrine, against the true teaching of the Almighty Father. The Holy Three, or the Holy Trinity, that had been popularized by Constantine the Great and through Athanasius, and had been fed to us through the ages, that we thought is the reality of what and who God is, is after all unmasked, and it is uncovered that it is one of the greatest deception that have damned the souls of millions into hell, believing they are saved when in fact they are not. I thank the Father that today that has been unmasked and uncovered. So anyone who will stay in those doctrines of deception should not fault anyone. Certainly, you cannot blame me, because an appointed Son was sent unto all of you, and an appointed Son, loyal and obedient to the Father's will, preached this manner of revelations without fear or favor. I am only here standing in loyalty to the one who sent me, the Almighty Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, who made me His residence and who made me His Son to deliver this message, being entrusted with the souls of all humanity, because that's the power, the sonship, where the salvation that can be received by anyone is only coming from the Almighty Father through His appointed Son. As John 17:2 says, that He has given the Son power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life unto all of those that the Father will give him. And I thank the Father that all of you who are listening, believing, and accepting my message, blessed are you, because you have been called and you have been chosen to receive the completion of this revelation. And I thank the Father that this generation listening to me today through satellite TV is one of the most blessed generation, because the Father has made a way for all of you to be able to listen to me, whether you are near or far. This technology the Father is using is a miracle in itself. You don't have to be physically present here in the cathedral in the New Jerusalem to receive my message. All you have to do is just access me through the internet, through satellite TV, Globecast World TV, through many, many technological means of mass media that are available. Radio, internet, TV, free TV, satellite TV. The Father is making a way for all of this so that people in our generation will be able to accept, will be able to listen to that message and make the proper decision of either rejecting or accepting that message. I thank the Father that today I am blessed to be chosen as the appointed son to deliver this message of the completion of man's salvation. I'm so glad that I did not remain a servant, but the Father made me a son, sent to the world, given to the world to declare and deliver this message. And I thank the Father that through this message, hundreds and thousands of souls who are in the graves of sin in the past are now resurrected to become sons and daughters, delivered and free of that serpent seed. This is the greatest message that have been heard since the beginning of time, because it was not uncovered, unraveled, and revealed unless a son is produced. Why is a son important to the Father? Because, first of all, if there's no sonship, there is no inheritance to talk about. Only the son will inherit eternal life. Only sons and daughters will inherit what the Father has. And the first thing that we have to inherit is eternal life. As we do not stay in this world any longer than the span of time given to you, or the span of life given to you. And after that, you will face the inevitable. You'll face the Almighty Father in judgment. And what will you tell him when he will judge you using these words that have been the standard of man's salvation? When he says that anyone that saith to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but they that do the will of my Father who is in heaven. You always hear me say that. The will of the Father is what is important in the lives of men and women today. And this is the most neglected message in the church age, and this is the most neglected message in the church age. The kingdom age was ushered, and this is the central message of the appointed Son of God. Focusing always on the Father's will. So I thank the Father that I'm not only harvesting sons and daughters, I am also harvesting workers, full-time miracle workers to help me in the great, bountiful, abundant, fruitful harvest of souls to become sons and daughters in these last days. Praise the Father. The harvest is truly great. Amen. The season of the great harvest is here. The gospel of the kingdom has already been preached all over the world. And the end has come. What's the end? The end of the Jewish age. The end of the church age. This is the beginning of the kingdom age. April 13, 2005 signals that the great harvest is here. It's in the offering and it's here. And all of those who are called, chosen, born again in the spirit of obedience to his will, did not remain infant, but had been made sons and daughters accountable, and later on became sons and daughters presentable. Have been given like a child is born, and after spiritual growth, a son is given. Now, not only one son is given, many, many sons and daughters are given to the world. Hallelujah! You are one of them. We are all involved in this as we mature and become sons and daughters. The Father will also harvest us and send us into all the world. So I'm harvesting not only souls to become sons and daughters or to become children of God or to be born in the spirit of obedience to his will. I'm also harvesting sons and daughters. There is a difference between a child and a son. A child is in the area of spiritual growth, growing. There is this possibility of you probably failing in the midst of your spiritual growth, because not all of us do have that mentality that should be the mentality of everyone born again in the spirit of obedience to his will, which is focusing only on his will no matter what. But some others are being deceived into using their freedom of choice to live out and to go out of the Father's will, using their freedom of choice, and are being deceived. Not many, but just a few. But to all of us who are like the appointed son, who have followed the Father's will, even in the infancy of your knowledge of him, that you don't know everything about his will, yet you have used your faith to follow him. And you determine in your heart by saying, whether I understand the will of the Father or not, whether at this moment I am confused or not, I choose to be strong in following the Father's will. I do not choose to be confused. I do not choose to be weak. I do not choose to remain weak. I choose to be strong. Amen. In following the Father's will. And the Father will give you the gift of faith. The gift of faith is a gift given to you when you ask for it. How many of you are weak in the faith? You ask the Father that gift. Father, give me the gift of faith. The gift of faith will give you strength to follow and will give you strength so that your freedom of choice will always be focused on the Father's will. And then after that, you will not remain in the children level or in the child level, in the infancy or in the child level. You will become a son and a daughter, accountable, responsible, just like your model, the appointed son. And the Father will usher you into his business. What's the Father's business? The harvest in his vineyard of souls. This is the greatest business. Harvesting souls for eternal life. Matthew 24:14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. What is that end again? The end of the Jewish age, the end of the church age, the beginning of the kingdom age. When did the kingdom age begin? When did the Jewish age ended? When did the church age ended? April 13, 2005. When did the kingdom age begin? When will it end? No end. The kingdom will be here forever and ever and ever. Praise the Father. Hallelujah. See, the harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels. You are the Father's angels. The harvest is the end of the world. End of the world of the Jewish age. End of the world of the church age. Beginning of the world of the kingdom age. That's why he said, you will have eternal life here and in the world to come. What is this world to come? It is the world of the kingdom age that began in April 13, 2005. Hallelujah. Are you glad, my brothers and sisters, that you are involved in the greatest work that is upon this earth today? All of these words that you have read before, but your eyes are still deceived and are still blinded by that deception. You don't understand any words that you are reading here, although they are written in your own language. Now you have the knowledge and the understanding of the revelation of these words, and we are in the midst of the Father's will. Praise the Father. Pagkagipanganak ka sa Espiritus pagtuman, di ka magpabiling bata, o dako ka, mahimo kang sama nako. Masang pagdako sa Espiritu, makompleto ang imong pagsabot sa yahang kabubuton. Di ka magpabiling bata, may mo ka ng anak. Ipadala ka na. Pagka na mo kang anak, wala ka niya to sa iyong business. Maputol ka. Mao man ay tuyo nga nung ikaw, mahimong anak. Mapareha ka sa kuha. Tugyanan ta sa bulaton samahan. This is the purpose. Why is producing sons and daughters? So that we will become responsible and accountable. Trustworthy sons and daughters entrusted with His work, with His business. What is the Father's business? Saving souls from the influence of Satan, Lucifer, the devil. From the influence of sin. What will be preached in all the world as a witness unto all nations? The gospel of the kingdom. It's not the gospel of the denomination or the gospel of the church or the gospel of the religion. It's the gospel of the kingdom. What is the gospel of the kingdom? Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is here. Matthew 4:17. The gospel of the kingdom shall be preached into all the world. Is it being preached into all the world today? As a witness unto all nations. The end has come. For all of these ages past, this is now the beginning of the new kingdom age. The harvest is the end of the world of the church age, the end of the world, of the Jewish age, and the beginning of the age of the kingdom. And the reapers are the angels. Who are those angels that will embody themselves? Angels who had been with Michael fighting against Lucifer, the devil, and they are now in the embodiment of the sons and daughters who have become like me and are engaged in the greatest spiritual work of saving those who have been deceived by Satan, Lucifer, the devil. So in these last days, I need for more laborers. With the massive expansion of the kingdom nation here on earth, the Father is calling more workers to be spread in the mission field. Who are those? Sons and daughters. You have no other choice. If you become a son and daughter, go full time now. You have no other choice. That is the reason why you're there. That's the reason why you are there. Hallelujah. That's the only reason why we become sons and daughters. It's not only your salvation. It is that the Father will use you as an instrument like me to be entrusted with all the responsibility of His business on earth. I am in my Father's business. You become sons and daughters, and you will also be recruited into the Father's business. Praise the Father. Hallelujah. Matthew 9:35-38, what does the Word of God say? Matthew 9:35-38, please read. See 37 and 38, please. Then saith he unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. Before, he used to employ servants, but servants are very deceptive in the church age and Jewish age, because they harvest the fruits and they do not return the fruits to him. They put it in their pockets. By what? By pocketing all the truth and then replacing them with their own version of the truth. They have interpreted the righteousness of God according to them, not according to God. When you do that, you are a deceptive laborer. You are pocketing the fruits, and you are not returning the fruits to the owner of the vineyard, which is our Lord. Now, in these last days, He has entrusted His work into the Son. Because the Son will never deceive the Father. The Son will be faithful in delivering the fruits to the Father. So if you believe me and accepted my message, you are not being owned by any denomination and religion. You are owned by the Father. So I did not hide repentance from you. I did not hide telling you that your human will is your serpent seed, that it was the devil who made a god out of you, that you had to surrender that and then receive a new seed of obedience to his will. I did not hide that from you. When you accepted and received that, and you have been born in the spirit of obedience to his will, you became sons and daughters, worthy to be called sons and daughters of the Father. So the Father owns you. You are not owned by anyone. It is the Father now who owns you. You are a fruit that had been returned to the rightful owner. You're bought with a price. You are not owned by any man. You are not owned by any religion and denomination. You're owned solely by the Father. So, it's not only one son that was called today, and through me, the Father has produced many sons and daughters. Can I trust you?
Amen.
Can the Father trust each one of you?
Amen.
You will not pocket my message.
Amen.
You will not change my message.
Amen.
You will not divert from the message.
Amen.
You will not change it. You will not twist it. You will deliver it exactly as I have delivered it unto you. Hallelujah. We are now sons and daughters entrusted with the business of the Father. Wala na yung mga ulipon nga saligan. Puro na anak ang mga pagasaligan karon. Because sons and daughters who are truly born again, the spirit of obedience to His will, are very, very loyal to Him. They are not diverted or they are not deceived by the lure of money, lure of power, lure of the flesh. They are not. They are always focused on the Father's will. They are willing to sacrifice everything for the Father's will. Hallelujah. These verses right now are being fulfilled and are in fulfillment. The harvest truly is plenteous, the laborers are few. All of those who are tuning in to me, this broadcast of the Appointed Sons satellite ministry was broadcasted when I was declared to the world as the Son. So it began in the year 2003. The satellite broadcast up to 2013 today. So 10 years of non-stop preaching of the Father's manna of revelation 24/7.
Amen.
The seed had been sown.
Amen.
The harvest are already there.
Amen.
And I need more laborers into the harvest.
Amen.
More sons and daughters involved into the harvest. We will harvest souls in spiritual revolution. We will harvest the abundance of the Father's blessings in financial revolution. And I will be harvesting all the talents needed in the revolution of excellence. We will use all of our talents, God-given talents, talents that the Father has given to us, not for the expansion of the influence of the serpent seed in the secular world. We will all be using that for the glory of the Father in His kingdom nation, as workers, sons and daughters who are working for Him, harvesting souls, engaging in the Father's business. Praise the Father Almighty. Hallelujah. So we will do as our Father did in His earthly ministry as the begotten Son. We will go into all the cities. Matthew 9:35, please go back to that. We'll go into all cities, villages. We will teach. We will preach the gospel of the kingdom.
Amen.
Heal every sickness.
Amen.
First of all, spiritual sickness. Every disease amongst the people. The greatest disease is self-deception, religious deception. These are interpreted not physically first, but spiritually first. Because right now, the gospel of the kingdom is spiritually delivered to the appointed Son is for the spirit and deliverance of the soul of man. So, spiritual na tanan usa. Ang kanang physical, human na kanang pahiling-hiling, physical healing, tumba-tumba. Muna akong natawag tumba-tumba ministry. Ligid-ligid, tumba-tumba ministry. Pagbangon nila, serpent seed lang yapon. Bisang kapila na yung muligiron, ang bitin, bitin lang yapon na. Pagbangon niya, bitin lang yapon siya. Oh, mo nang ang pagkabitin, may atong kuwaon.
Amen.
Balag niligid kag wala, basta na ginulsul ka, di nakabitin.
Amen.
So, the ligid-ligid ministry is over. The gulong-gulong ministry is over. Huh? The physical healing ministry is over. Spiritually first, we will heal all the disease and sickness of the people spiritually, and the cure is amongst us, sons and daughters. What is the cure? The message. Tell everyone, repent. Surrender the cause of your disease. Surrender the cause of your sickness. Surrender the cause of your spiritual disease and sickness. Surrender the devil's serpent seed. And automatically you will be healed, because you'll be given a new spirit of healing, which is the spirit of obedience to the Father's will. Only healthy people can obey the Father. Only spiritually healthy, alive people can obey the Father. How can you obey when you're dead? You're not even sick, you're dead. So we'll be doing us what the Father has done. Then, our Almighty Father saw the multitudes. He was moved with compassion because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Are they really having no shepherd? They have physical shepherds before. They have Jewish leaders. He was talking here spiritually. No one was feeding them spiritual food. They are all being deceived. Now, what the Father has seen when he was here, as the begotten Son in his earthly ministry, I am also seeing in my ministry as the appointed Son. These people in the church age are all scattered. They have no shepherd. They have no shepherd to feed them spiritual food. But thank the Father that he has sent the real shepherd of the soul of man. He came down in the second coming, embodied himself in the flesh. He is calling that his residence, his temple. And he is the one feeding his children to his appointed Son. The real Savior of your soul has come back. To find you, my brothers and sisters. Will you join the appointed Son?
Amen.
Sons and daughters, whether you like it or not, that is the reason why you have to grow spiritually. Muna inungdan kinalan, magtubo tao, mahimutang mga tinuod nga anak nga babaeng lalaki. Aron pagkatapos, rekruto na ta samahan, nga nang gimo kang anak lalaki, ba paano mahimo kang responsable? Di ka magpabiling bata. When you remain children, infant, that is where the irresponsibilities and inaccountabilities are. But why did the Father let you grow into becoming sons and daughters? And sons and daughters will be given to the world. Why? So that we will become accountable and responsible, and we will be entrusted with the Father's business here on earth, which is reaping the harvest of his vineyard of souls. You are all going to become like me. That is one of the reasons why you are here. If you fail that, and you just grow, and you did not realize that, you will become a branch that will not bear fruit. And if you become a branch that will not bear fruit, and the Father visited you, putlong ka, you will be cut off. He said, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest. John 4:35. This is the twofold instruction in reaping. What? Lift up your eyes. Tanaw. Look. Stop, look. Lift up your eyes. Look on the fields. Set your minds on things above. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. When you become a son and a daughter, you forget about your self-centered motives of life. I want to succeed. I want to become rich myself. I want to pursue a degree. I want to pursue my business for myself. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. What are the things above? The Father's business is number one. Stop focusing in on self. John 21:15-16. Feed my lambs. Feed my sheep. This is the command of our Almighty Father that should be fulfilled in all sons and daughters. Lift up your eyes. Tanaw. Look on the fields. Tanawa ang kaumahan. Puti na kaayo. Andam ng pag-aanihon. Lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are all white, all ready to harvest. Pagkawalay mag-harvest na, mga tagak na sila tanan, kita'y blame sa amahan. Mga wala. Praise the Father. Praise the Father.
Praise the Father.
So, kakita na ta sa pagpanginahanglan.
Amen.
Kakita na ta sa kaumahan.
Amen.
The field is the world. Many, many of you who have been here before, who have become sons and daughters, became full-time miracle workers, are sent into the harvest field, which is the world. Many of them are not here now. Some are assigned in Asia, some in Europe, in Middle East, some in North and South America, some in Canada, all over the world. We are filling the world. But we still need more laborers. That's why we don't focus on ourselves. The Father is entrusting the work of His business into our hands, my brothers and sisters. We will not fail the Father Almighty. Bringing in the harvest demands time and urgency. If reaping is delayed, the fruits will fall into the ground and will be damaged. The Father wants to stress the imperative of getting into the fields before it's too late. We need to be active and aggressive in reaping. Praise the Father. Hallelujah. How many souls comes April 25, 2015, and more.
Amen.
Praise the Father. In time of the dedication and the ribbon cutting of the opening of the kingdom, how many is the demand of the Almighty Father's disappointed Son in the harvest? That's why we need more laborers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Planting season is over. I have planted the seed. You are my helpers.
Amen.
The seed is growing. It has grown. Many are already ready to harvest. Praise the Father. So when the harvest is ready, what will we do? We will put in the sickle to the harvest. Praise the Father. Mark 4:29. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he put it in the sickle, because the harvest is come. But when the fruit is brought forth, fruiting season na ni, tigpamunga na ni. Walay mga anak na magtulog-tulog sa panahon sa harvest. A son and a daughter sleeping in the time of the harvest is a shame to his parents. Makaulaw mo pagka nagtulog-tulog mo sa panahon sa pagpangani. Kamong tanan, kabati sa akong tingog, mga anak mo, akauban nako niini nga harvest. So, now is the time of that harvest. That's why 2013 is the year of bountiful, abundant, bountiful, fruitful harvest. Both in spiritual revolution, financial revolution, and the revolution of excellence. Proverbs 10:5, he that gathereth in summer is a wise son, but he that sleepeth in harvest is a son that causeth shame. Read that in Tagalog, please.
Opo, Pastor, sa mga kawikaan, Kapitulo 5. Siyang nagtitipon sa tag-init ay pantas na anak, ngunit siyang natutulog sa pag-aani ay anak na kahiyahiya.
Siyang nagtitipon sa panahon ng tag-init, yung nagha-harvest panahon ng tag-init, ay isang pantas na anak. Pero siyang natutulog sa panahon ng harvest, ano daw siya? Kahiyahiya. Bisaya.
Sa Bisaya, Pastor. Proverbio 10:5. Kadtong nagaani panahon sa ting-init, may usa ka manggi-alamon nga anak. Apan kadtong nagkatulog sa ting-ani, may usa ka anak nga nagapakaulaw.
Ukraine. Alina.
Собирающий во время лета, сын разумный. Спящий же во время жатвы, сын беспутный.
Спутник дал, ан канангат тулуг-тулуг. Что мог моему спутник?
Беспутный се.
А?
Беспутный. Беспутный.
Беспутный?
Yes.
А-а-а. Abi ko Sputnik. So, malipayon ta nga nakita na nako ang dako kaayong alanihon. Kamo pod nakakita na sa dako kaayong alanihon. Masaya tayo mga kapatid, nakikita natin ang napakalaking ani ng mga kalno. Hindi lang ako nakakita ng malaking ani ngayon, pati na kayo nakakita ng napakalaki. Ah, lahat tayo dito involved. Hallelujah. Kaya't in time of our inauguration in April 25, 2015 of the kingdom, the great harvest demanded of us will begin here and will spread all over the world. We will all be involved in the Father's business. Sons and daughters, this is now the time for us to rise up. Be aggressive. Woo! Be aggressive. The harvest is also a time of joy. Harvest is a time of rejoicing. Keepers Club International, here in Davao City, I want 10,000 souls, 10,000 young people from all schools. Keepers Club members, you are called by the Almighty Father to dedicate your young life to Him, to serve Him, to sing in our kingdom choir. Hallelujah. We need a 10,000 voice choir of young people. And truly the Father is going to pick each one of you. Tanang lingkuralan sa kingdom na nanay pangalan. Praise the Father. Ayaw ihatag sa uban ang imong pangalan. Let your name be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Let your name be written in heaven. Let your seat be filled by you. Let your name be known in heaven. This is the kingdom of heaven here on earth. I am now opening the gates of the kingdom to all the sons and daughters that are out there, and you will be harvested. Wala niyang panahon sa dakong ani, pasudlon na nato ang tanang mga anak, lalaki o babae. Welcome to the kingdom. Let's give Him one big hand clap offering. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Father's name. Praise the Father's name forever. Woo!
that no one could ever see me. Father, for the man of revelation today, bless everyone that have joined me in this live telecast of Sounds of Worship, wherever they are. We thank you, Father, that your words from man of revelation have made their way into their hearts and minds, especially your children, sons and daughters in the kingdom nation, who are now joining the appointed son in the great harvest of souls to become sons and daughters all over the world. Thank you, Father. You that are waiting, you that have listened to my message, you have been called and chosen by the Father. This is now the time for you to come. Kingdom nations' gates are open for all the souls, for all the fruits of the harvest. Thank you, Father, once again for the declaration of year 2013 to be the bountiful, abundant, fruitful harvest in your kingdom nation. Thank you, Father. Bless all your children today. Bless them once more with the miracles of healing, with the bountiful harvest of financial and material blessings that they need, and with the bountiful harvests of enlightenment. Each one of them will be visited by the Spirit of your salvation. You will have knowledge, understanding of this manner of revelation today as a gift of enlightenment.
in the Father's almighty name. We give you back the glory, the honor, and the praise, and the thanksgiving. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Let's give him one big hand clap offering. Praise the Father Almighty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the church age, the kingdom age was ushered, and this is the central message of the appointed Son of God. Focusing always on the Father's will. So I thank the Father that I'm not only harvesting sons and daughters, I am also harvesting workers, full-time miracle workers to help me in the great, bountiful, abundant, fruitful harvest of souls to become sons and daughters in these last days. Praise the Father. The harvest is truly great. Amen. The season of the great harvest is here. The gospel of the kingdom has already been preached all over the world. And the end has come. What's the end? The end of the Jewish age. The end of the church age. This is the beginning of the kingdom age. April 13, 2005 signals that the great harvest is here. It's in the offering and it's here. And all of those who are called, chosen, born again in the spirit of obedience to his will, did not remain infant, but had been made sons and daughters accountable, and later on became sons and daughters presentable. Have been given, like a child is born, and after spiritual growth, a son is given. Now, not only one son is given, many, many sons and daughters are given to the world. Hallelujah. You are one of them. We are all involved in this. As we mature and become sons and daughters, the Father will also harvest us and send us into all the world. So I'm harvesting not only souls to become sons and daughters, or to become children of God, or to be born in the spirit of obedience to his will. I'm also harvesting sons and daughters. There is a difference between a child and a son. A child is in the area of spiritual growth, growing. There is this possibility of you probably failing in the midst of your spiritual growth, because not all of us do have that mentality that should be the mentality of everyone born again in the spirit of obedience to his will, which is focusing only on his will no matter what. But some others are being deceived into using their freedom of choice to live out and to go out of the Father's will, using their freedom of choice, and are being deceived. Not many, but just a few. But to all of us who are like the appointed son, who have followed the Father's will, even in the infancy of your knowledge of him, that you don't know everything about his will, yet you have used your faith to follow him. And you determine in your heart by saying, whether I understand the will of the Father or not, whether at this moment I am confused or not, I choose to be strong in following the Father's will. I do not choose to be confused. I do not choose to be weak. I do not choose to remain weak. I choose to be strong in following the Father's will. And the Father will give you the gift of faith. The gift of faith is a gift given to you when you ask for it. How many of you are weak in the faith? You ask the Father that gift. Father, give me the gift of faith. The gift of faith will give you strength to follow and will give you strength so that your freedom of choice will always be focused on the Father's will. And then after that, you will not remain in the children level or in the child level, in the infancy or in the child level. You will become a son and a daughter, accountable, responsible, just like your model, the appointed son. And the Father will usher you into his business. What's the Father's business? The harvest in his vineyard of souls. This is the greatest business. Harvesting souls for eternal life. Matthew 24:14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. What is that end again? The end of the Jewish age, the end of the church age, the beginning of the kingdom age. When did the kingdom age begin? When did the Jewish age ended? When did the church age ended? April 13, 2005. When did the kingdom age begin? When will it end? No end. The kingdom will be here forever and ever and ever. Praise the Father. Hallelujah. See, the harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels. You are the Father's angels. The harvest is the end of the world. End of the world of the Jewish age. End of the world of the church age. Beginning of the world of the kingdom age. That's why he said, you will have eternal life here and in the world to come. What is this world to come? It is the world of the kingdom age that began in April 13, 2005. Hallelujah. Are you glad, my brothers and sisters, that you are involved in the greatest work that is upon this earth today? All of this words that you have read before, but your eyes are still deceived and are still blinded by that deception. You don't understand any words that you are reading here, although they are written in your own language. Now you have the knowledge and the understanding of the revelation of these words, and we are in the midst of the Father's will. Praise the Father. Pagkagipanganak ka sa Espiritu sa pagtuman, di ka magpabiling bata, o dako ka, mahimo kang sama nako. Masang pagdako sa Espiritu, makompleto ang imong pagsabot sa yahang kabubuton. Di ka magpabiling bata, mahimo ka ng anak. Ipadala ka na. Pagka mahimo kang anak, wala ka niya to sa iyong business, maputol ka. Maumanay tuyo nga nung ikaw mahimong anak, mapareha ka sa kuha. Tugyanan ta sa bulaton samahan. This is the purpose why is producing sons and daughters, so that we will become responsible and accountable, trustworthy sons and daughters, entrusted with his work, with his business. What is the Father's business? Saving souls from the influence of Satan, Lucifer, the devil. From the influence. To all of those who are joining us for the first time viewers and watchers of this program, it's not an accident that you have tuned in today. It is the Father's perfect appointment and time for you. Because the Father is calling thousands of His children to the great harvest today. So I thank the Father also for all of the new full-time miracle workers who are joining me in the bountiful, abundant, and fruitful harvest of souls to become sons and daughters all over the Philippines and all over the world. I thank the Father that the message that have been completed for man's completion of salvation is upon us. And this is the hope of every soul. This is the hope of humanity. And this is the hope by which man can find the broken relationship between him and the Almighty Father brought back. I thank the Father that today when the Father opens up the gates of the door of salvation, anyone who is hungry and thirsty for that salvation will find completion in the Father's work of salvation. This is your ark of salvation today. Praise the Almighty Father. Every question in our hearts are being answered. Lahat ng tanong sa ating mga buhay tungkol sa kaligtasan, nasagot na lahat. Tanang mga pangutana na wala na to nasulbad sa una, karon nasulbad na natanan. All of those questions are being answered today by the message of the Almighty Father through His appointed Son. And so, I thank the Father for that, the ramparts and the walls, thick walls of religious deception are going down. For example, the religious deception of our belief that had been fed to us, that those doctrines have been exposed against the true doctrine, against the true teaching of the Almighty Father. The Holy Three, or the Holy Trinity, that had been popularized by Constantine the Great and through Athanasius and had been fed to us through the ages, that we thought is the reality of what and who God is, is after all unmasked and it is uncovered that it is one of the greatest deception that have damned the souls of millions into hell, believing they are saved when in fact they are not. I thank the Father that today that has been unmasked and uncovered. So anyone who will stay in those doctrines of deception should not fault anyone. Certainly, you cannot blame me, because an appointed Son was sent unto all of you, and an appointed Son, loyal and obedient to the Father's will, preached this manner of revelations without fear or favor. I am only here standing in loyalty to the one who sent me, the Almighty Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, who made me His residence and who made me His Son to deliver this message, being entrusted with the souls of all humanity. Because that's the power, the sonship, where the salvation that can be received by anyone is only coming from the Almighty Father through His appointed Son. As John 17:2 says, that He has given the Son power over all flesh, that He should give eternal life unto all of those that the Father will give Him. And I thank the Father that all of you who are listening, believing, and accepting my message, blessed are you, because you have been called and you have been chosen to receive the completion of this revelation. And I thank the Father that this generation listening to me today through satellite TV is one of the most blessed generation, because the Father has made a way for all of you to be able to listen to me, whether you are near or far. This technology the Father is using is a miracle in itself. You don't have to be physically present here in the cathedral in the New Jerusalem to receive my message. All you have to do is just access me through the internet, through satellite TV, Globecast World TV, through many, many technological means of mass media that are available. Radio, internet, TV, free TV, satellite TV. The Father is making a way for all of this so that people in our generation will be able to accept, will be able to listen to that message and make the proper decision of either rejecting or accepting that message. I thank the Father that today I am blessed to be chosen as the appointed son to deliver this message of the completion of man's salvation. I'm so glad that I did not remain a servant, but the Father made me a son. Amen. Sent to the world, given to the world, to declare and deliver this message. And I thank the Father that through this message, hundreds and thousands of souls who are in the graves of sin in the past are now resurrected to become sons and daughters, delivered and free of that serpent seed. This is the greatest message that have been heard since the beginning of time, because it was not uncovered, unraveled, and revealed unless a son is produced. Why is a son important to the Father? Because, first of all, if there's no sonship, there is no inheritance to talk about. Only the son will inherit eternal life. Only sons and daughters will inherit what the Father has. And the first thing that we have to inherit is eternal life. As we do not stay in this world any longer than the span of time given to you, or the span of life given to you. And after that, you will face the inevitable. You'll face the Almighty Father in judgment. And what will you tell Him when He will judge you using these words that have been the standard of man's salvation? When He says, not anyone that saith to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but they that do the will of my Father who is in heaven. You always hear me say that. The will of the Father is what is important in the lives of men and women today. And this is the most neglected message in the church age, and this is the most neglected message of sin. What will be preached in all the world as a witness unto all nations? The gospel of the kingdom. It's not the gospel of the denomination or the gospel of the church or the gospel of the religion. It's the gospel of the kingdom. What is the gospel of the kingdom? Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is here. Matthew 4:17. The gospel of the kingdom shall be preached into all the world. Is it being preached into all the world today?
Yes.
As a witness unto all nations, the end has come. For all of these ages past, this is now the beginning of the new kingdom age. The harvest is the end of the world of the church age, the end of the world of the Jewish age, and the beginning of the age of the kingdom. And the reapers are the angels. Who are those angels that will embody themselves? Angels who had been with Michael fighting against Lucifer, the devil, and they are now in the embodiment of the sons and daughters who have become like me and are engaged in the greatest spiritual work of saving those who have been deceived by Satan, Lucifer, the devil. So in these last days, I need for more laborers. With the massive expansion of the kingdom nation here on earth, the Father is calling more workers to be spread in the mission field. Who are those? Sons and daughters. You have no other choice. If you become a son and daughter, go full time now. Amen. You have no other choice. That is the reason why you're there. That's the reason why you are there. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. That's the only reason why we become sons and daughters. It's not only your salvation. It is that the Father will use you as an instrument like me to be entrusted with all the responsibility of His business on earth. Yes. I am in my Father's business. You become sons and daughters, and you will also be recruited into the Father's business. Praise the Father. Hallelujah. Matthew 9:35-38. What does the Word of God say? Matthew 9:35-38. Please read. Verses 37 and 38, please. Then saith he unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. Before, he used to employ servants, but servants are very deceptive in the church age and Jewish age, because they harvest the fruits and they do not return the fruits to him. They put it in their pockets. By what? By pocketing all the truth and then replacing them with their own version of the truth. They have interpreted the righteousness of God according to them, not according to God. When you do that, you are a deceptive laborer. You are pocketing the fruits, and you are not returning the fruits to the owner of the vineyard, which is our Lord. Now, in these last days, he has entrusted his work into the Son. Because the Son will never deceive the Father. The Son will be faithful in delivering the fruits to the Father. So if you believe me and accepted my message, you are not being owned by any denomination and religion. You are owned by the Father. I did not hide repentance from you. I did not hide telling you that your human will is your serpent seed, that it was the devil who made a god out of you, that you had to surrender that and then receive a new seed of obedience to his will. I did not hide that from you. When you accepted and received that, and you have been born in the spirit of obedience to His will, you became sons and daughters, worthy to be called sons and daughters of the Father. So the Father owns you. You are not owned by anyone. It is the Father now who owns you. You are a fruit that had been returned to the rightful owner. You're bought with a price. You are not owned by any man. You are not owned by any religion and denomination. You're owned solely by the Father. So, it's not only one son that was called today, and through me, the Father has produced many sons and daughters. Can I trust you?
Amen.
Can the Father trust each one of you?
Amen.
You will not pocket my message.
Amen.
You will not change my message.
Amen.
You will not divert from the message.
Amen.
You will not change it. You will not twist it. You will deliver it exactly as I have delivered it unto you. Hallelujah. We are now sons and daughters entrusted with the business of the Father. Wala na yung mga ulipon nga saligan. Puro na anak ang mga pagasaligan karon. Because sons and daughters who are truly born again, the spirit of obedience to His will, are very, very loyal to Him. They are not diverted or they are not deceived by the lure of money, lure of power, lure of the flesh. They are not. They are always focused on the Father's will. They are willing to sacrifice everything for the Father's will. Hallelujah. These verses right now are being fulfilled and are in fulfillment. The harvest truly is plenteous, the laborers are few. All of those who are tuning in to me, this broadcast of the Pointed Sons satellite ministry was broadcasted when I was declared to the world as the Son. So it began in the year 2003, the satellite broadcast, up to 2013 today. So 10 years of non-stop preaching of the Father's man of revelation 24/7.
Amen.
The seed had been sown.
Amen.
The harvest are already there.
Amen.
And I need more laborers into the harvest.
Amen.
More sons and daughters involved into the harvest. We will harvest souls in spiritual revolution. We will harvest the abundance of the Father's blessings in financial revolution. And I will be harvesting all the talents needed in the revolution of excellence. We will use all of our talents, God-given talents, talents that the Father has given to us, not for the expansion to our hands, my brothers and sisters. We will not fail the Father Almighty. Bringing in the harvest demands time and urgency. If reaping is delayed, the fruits will fall into the ground and will be damaged. The Father wants to stress the imperative of getting into the fields before it's too late. We need to be active and aggressive in reaping. Praise the Father. Hallelujah. How many souls comes April 25, 2015? And more.
Amen.
Praise the Father. In time of the dedication and the ribbon cutting of the opening of the kingdom, how many is the demand of the Almighty Father's appointed Son in the harvest? That's why we need more laborers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Planting season is over. I have planted the seed. You are my helpers. The seed is growing. It has grown. Many are already ready to harvest. Praise the Father. So when the harvest is ready, what will we do? We will put in the sickle to the harvest. Praise the Father. Mark 4:29. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he put it in the sickle, because the harvest is come. But when the fruit is brought forth, fruiting season na ni, tigpamunga na ni. Walay mga anak na magtulog-tulog sa panahon sa harvest. A son and a daughter sleeping in the time of the harvest is a shame to his parents. Makaulaw mo pagka nagtulog-tulog mo sa panahon sa pagpangani. Kamong tanan, nakabati sa akong tingog, mga anak mo, nakauban nako nining harvest. So, now is the time of that harvest. That's why 2013 is the year of bountiful, abundant, bountiful, fruitful harvest. Both in spiritual revolution, financial revolution, and the revolution of excellence. Proverbs 10:5, he that gathereth in summer is a wise son, but he that sleepeth in harvest is a son that causeth shame. Read that in Tagalog, please.
Opo, Pastor, sa mga kawikaan, Kapitulo 5. Siyang nagtitipon sa tag-init ay pantas na anak, ngunit siyang natutulog sa pag-aani ay anak na kahiyahiya.
Siyang nagtitipon sa panahon ng tag-init, yung nag-harvest panahon ng tag-init, ay isang pantas na anak. Pero siyang natutulog sa panahon ng harvest, ano daw siya? Kahiyahiya. Bisaya.
Sa Bisaya, Pastor, Proverbio 10:5. Kadtong nagaani panahon sa ting-init, may usa ka manggi-alamon nga anak. Apan kadtong nagkatulog sa ting-ani, may usa ka anak nga nagapakaulaw.
Ukraine. Alina.
Собирающий во время лета, сын разумный. Спящий же во время жатвы, сын беспутный.
Спутник дал, ан канангат тулуг-тулуг. Что мог моему спутник?
Беспутный сын.
А?
Беспутный. Беспутный.
Беспутный?
Yes.
Abi ko Sputnik. So, malipayon ta nga nakita na nako ang dako kaayong alanihon. Kamo pod nakakita na sa dako kaayong alanihon. Masaya tayo mga kapatid, nakikita natin ang napakalaking ani ng mga kalno. Hindi lang ako nakakita ng malaking ani ngayon, pati na kayo nakakita ng napakalaki. Lahat tayo dito involved. Hallelujah. Kaya't in time of our inauguration in April 25, 2015 of the kingdom, the great harvest demanded of us will begin here and will spread all over the world. We will all be involved in the Father's business. Sons and daughters, this is now the time for us to rise up. Be aggressive. Woo! Be aggressive. The harvest is also a time of joy. Harvest is a time of rejoicing. Keepers Club International, here in Davao City, I want 10,000 souls, 10,000 young people from all schools. Keepers Club members, you are called by the Almighty Father to dedicate your young life to Him, to serve Him, to sing in our Kingdom Choir. Hallelujah. We need a 10,000 voice choir of young people. And truly the Father is going to pick each one of you. Tanang lingkuralan sa kingdom na nanay pangalan. Praise the Father. Ayaw ihatag sa uban ang imong pangalan. Let your name be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Let your name be written in heaven. Let your seat be filled by you. Let your name be known in heaven. This is the kingdom of heaven here on earth. I am now opening the gates of the kingdom to all the sons and daughters that are out there, and you will be harvested. Wala niyang panahon sa dakong ani, pasudlo na nato ang tanang mga anak, lalaki o babae. Welcome to the kingdom. Let's give Him one big hand clap offering. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Father's name. Expansion of the influence of the serpent seed in the secular world. We will all be using that for the glory of the Father in His kingdom nation, as workers, sons and daughters who are working for Him, harvesting souls, engaging in the Father's business. Praise the Father Almighty. Hallelujah. So we will do as our Father did in His earthly ministry as the begotten Son. We will go into all the cities. Matthew 9:35, please go back to that. We'll go into all cities, villages. We will teach. We will preach the gospel of the kingdom. Heal every sickness. Amen. First of all, spiritual sickness. Amen. Every disease. Amen. Amongst the people. The greatest disease is self-deception, religious deception. These are interpreted not physically first, but spiritually first. Amen. Because right now, the gospel of the kingdom is spiritually delivered to the appointed Son is for the spirit and deliverance of the soul of man. So, spiritual na tanan usa. Ang kanang physical, human na kanang pahiling-hiling, physical healing, tumba-tumba. O na akong natawag tumba-tumba ministry. Ligid-ligid, tumba-tumba ministry. Pagbangon nila, serpent seed lang yapon. Bisang kapila na mo ligiron, ang bitin-bitin lang yapon na. Pagbangon niya, bitin lang yapon siya. Mo nang ang pagkabitin may atong kuwaon. Amen. Balag niligid kag wala, basta naginulsol ka, di nakabitin. Amen. So the ligid-ligid ministry is over. The gulong-gulong ministry is over. Huh? The physical healing ministry is over. Spiritually first, we will heal all the disease and sickness of the people spiritually, and the cure is amongst us, sons and daughters. What is the cure? The message. Tell everyone, repent. Surrender the cause of your disease. Surrender the cause of your sickness. Surrender the cause of your spiritual disease and sickness. Surrender the devil's serpent seed. And automatically you will be healed, because you'll be given a new spirit of healing, which is the spirit of obedience to the Father's will. Only healthy people can obey the Father. Only spiritually healthy, alive people can obey the Father. How can you obey when you're dead? You're not even sick, you're dead. So we'll be doing us what the Father has done. Then our Almighty Father saw the multitudes. He was moved with compassion, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Are they really having no shepherd? They have physical shepherds before. They have Jewish leaders. He was talking here spiritually. No one was feeding them spiritual food. They are all being deceived. Now, what the Father has seen when he was here, as the begotten Son in his earthly ministry, I am also seeing in my ministry as the appointed Son. These people in the church age are all scattered. They have no shepherd. They have no shepherd to feed them spiritual food. But thank the Father that he has sent the real shepherd of the soul of man. He came down in the second coming, embodied himself in the flesh. He is calling that his residence, his temple. And he is the one feeding his children to his appointed Son. The real Savior of your soul has come back. Yes. To find you, my brothers and sisters. Will you join the appointed Son?
Yes.
Sons and daughters, whether you like it or not, that is the reason why you have to grow spiritually. Muna inungdan kinalan, magtubo tao, mahimutang mga tinuod nga anak nga babaeng lalaki. Aron pagkatapos rekruto na ta samahan, ganang gimo ko anak lalaki, ba para mahimo kang responsable. Di ka magpabiling bata. When you remain children and infant, that is where the irresponsibilities and inaccountabilities are. But why did the Father let you grow into becoming sons and daughters? And sons and daughters will be given to the world. Why? So that we will become accountable and responsible, and we will be entrusted with the Father's business here on earth, which is reaping the harvest of his vineyard of souls. You are all going to become like me. That is one of the reasons why you are here. If you fail that, and you just grow, and you did not realize that, you will become a branch that will not bear fruit. And if you become a branch that will not bear fruit and the Father visited you, putlon ka, you will be cut off. He said, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest. John 4:35. This is the twofold instruction in reaping. What? Lift up your eyes. Tanaw. Look. Stop, look. Lift up your eyes. Look on the fields. Set your minds on things above, Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. When you become a son and a daughter, you forget about your self-centered motives of life. I want to succeed. I want to become rich myself. I want to pursue a degree. I want to pursue my business for myself. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. What are the things above? The Father's business is number one. Stop focusing in on self. John 21:15-16. Feed my lambs. Feed my sheep. This is the command of our Almighty Father that should be fulfilled in all sons and daughters. Lift up your eyes. Tanaw. Look on the fields. Tanawa ang kaumahan. Puti na kaayo. Andam ng pag-aanihon. Lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest. Pagkawalay mag-harvest na, mga tagak na sila tanan, kita'y blame sa amahan. Mga wala. Praise the Father. Praise the Father.
Praise the Father.
So, kakita na ta sa pagpanginahanglan. Kakita na ta sa kaumahan. The field is the world. Many of you who have been here before, who have become sons and daughters, became full-time miracle workers, are sent into the harvest field, which is the world. Many of them are not here now. Some are assigned in Asia, some in Europe, in Middle East, some in North and South America, some in Canada, all over the world. We are filling the world. But we still need more laborers. That's why we don't focus on ourselves. The Father is entrusting the work of His business in